What's up, guys? My name is Marcus Huskins. Thank you for joining me. If you enjoy what I do, be sure to like, comment, share, and subscribe. And also be sure to hit that notification bell so you can be made aware as new content becomes available. In a previous video, we took a look at working with Pattern Editor and Pattern Parts in Studio One. One thing that I wanted to get to, but I thought I would do it in a separate video, is with respect to sharing or saving different presets. Okay. So if you open up the inspector when you're working with Pattern Parts, we have these two options over here. I can store and I can load. Now, what does this mean? Okay, let's create a couple different variations of this over here. And I could get rid of some of these different parts. We'll go to variation two. Maybe I want to get rid of this. Whatever we need to do, anything that needs to be done to make these different. So what ends up happening is we have one pattern part with four different variations. Now, if you wanted to share this, or you wanted to basically save it to be used in different productions, future productions, we have two really easy options to be able to do this. One of them is I can just click the store button, and then I can give this pattern part a name. If we have a subfolder, we can put it in the subfolder. We can also give it a description. So let's call this basic pattern, and now I click OK. And now you'll notice if I go to load, I have basic pattern. So the thing to note, though, with respect to presets and pattern parts is that they could be different depending on what preset you're using. What do I mean by this? Well, if I scroll over to another preset, like what do we have here? Let me go to my MH Music and let's go to my 909 kit. In my 909 kit, this might not necessarily be the same mapping. Now, that may come up with some really cool creative surprises, but it's just one thing to be aware of when you're working with storing presets. So we have the one option over here to store it like this. And another thing that we can do is if I go to browse, let me zoom out a little bit and let's change the length of this pattern. Let's just make it a one bar pattern part. And I'm going to zoom this out a little bit. If I go into files, I've got a file folder that's in my Studio One browser. If I drag and drop this into the browser and I hold the Alt or Option key, I can toggle between a music loop and a pattern file. Now, if I leave this set on pattern file, when I let go, this is exported that pattern. What that means is that this pattern can be dragged and dropped in from the Studio One browser. One other thing to note about pattern parts and when you're storing them is presets. Let's open up our Studio One instruments here. And let me drag and drop something in that I know I've created a pattern part. So let's drag and drop this one here. And I'm going to go to a preset. We'll go with this particular preset over here. Now, if I was to create a blank pattern part, now I double click this. I can now load. Let's go to Sounds Famous. This one over here. You'll notice that all the information that's retained here. So we have all the different variations. So if I click this, I have an intro variation. I've got chorus A, chorus B, bridge A, bridge B, break, ending. So it's a really, really cool way to be able to store basic drum files and presets and grooves and stuff like that. One thing worth noting though is maybe consider putting something to do with the preset in the name so you know where it came from. Or if you build your own kits and you always build them the same way, where you have your kicks on a certain pitch, your hi-hats, and maybe your snares, this would be a great way to have different impact kits or different patterns and different grooves and variations. You could simply store them using this method, or you could drag them and drop them to a folder in your browser. And both of those can be recalled. The pattern part name and all the variations will come with it. Anyways, that's all the time I have available for today. If you enjoyed this content, please consider hitting that subscribe button. Any questions or comments, leave them down below. I'll do my absolute best to get back to you. And as always, we will catch you in the next video. Cheers.